when I go to grab the gun in the holster to pull it out, I only grab the gun one way. And that's with a full high firing grip on the gun. So you see where my thumb is? My thumb is up and high, and then the flesh of the web of my hand is being compressed against the back strap. And my finger is indexed right where it's supposed to be as the gun comes out. Okay, that's what my shooting hand is doing. Then my support hand, one of the things we want to think about is front loading. So we want to do as much as we can, as early as we can in the process, so that in the end, when we're focusing on like pulling the trigger, we have less to think about. Right? So if I know that my hand has to go on the gun and my wrist is going to be canted as I grip the gun with a full firing grip, then I might as well cant it back here. Okay? So I grip with my shooting hand, full firing grip on the gun, my support hand comes to my chest right here. Okay? So that's going to be the grip. So go ahead and everyone is relaxed and then grip. The next step is going to be pulling the gun up out of the holster until your shoulder binds. Okay? So I grip and then I'll say click. And you come up as high as you can until your shoulder binds. Okay? For some people, that's going to be different spots depending on their shoulder flexibility and range of motion. So one other point, stepping forward, one other point with this is that I'm indexing this whole thing off of my body. I don't do this out in space, right? I don't do anything out in space, because if I do it out in space, I don't have a reference point and it's not going to be consistent. Okay? We want to find consistency in how we draw the gun. So I'm riding the rails of my body, whether I'm shooting a duty holster or whether I'm shooting a concealment holster. So I am physically indexed here against my rib cage, like that. Okay. Grip, clear, and I'm back in the holster. Next thing is going to be the lock position. So I grip the gun, I clear out of the holster until my shoulder binds, and I rotate the muzzle up. What I don't do is drop my shoulder. Okay, or drop my elbow. If I drop my elbow, if you look at the gun carefully, reference to my body, here, I come up here and then I drop my elbow, my gun's actually lowering a little bit. So what I want to do is just, see that difference there? My muzzle's just coming up.
So more wrist.
So yeah, it's all in the wrist. And really at speed, what we're going to do is we're just going to snatch the gun out of the holster and it just pops, it hits stop point and the muzzle just pops up on its own, okay, at speed. But administratively for holster and unholster, we'll break it down into subcomponents. So I grip, clear, lock. And again, that lock position, right, is referenced here. My thumb is actually against my pectoral, right? And so if I shoot from here, my slide will reciprocate just fine. I don't have to rotate my hand over like this because my thumb is ensuring that my slide is not interfering with any garment or anything that I'm wearing. And it's gonna look like this. Grip, clear, lock, ready. Coming here into the ready position. Okay, full firing grip. And obviously we haven't talked about what a full firing grip is yet, but we will get to that later on. So grip, clear, lock, ready. Good. Break your apart, come on down. If you go from grip to here, because you're going at speed, I don't have a problem with that if it's just coming up, right? Because that's really where it probably needs to be anyway. So your grip. And then as you go, you pull it up till the shoulder binds and it's just rotating up. That's what should be happening and that's fine. Grip, clear, lock, ready. Cool. One of the important points on the reholster that I want to make is I only do things one way, right? And that's whether I'm going out to the target or whether I'm coming back to the target. I just do it in reverse. And so when I go back into the holster, a super common thing that we see is this. Right? And I don't understand that. I understand that just as it's kind of a lazy habit that we do, but it's not deliberate. There's nothing deliberate about it, right? Because I don't know. I mean, essentially, it's like I've lost control of my gun, and now I got to shove my gun in my holster. It's like maintain full control of your gun until your gun is secure. Your gun is not secure right now, right? If this is my gun, is it secure? Nope. So I should maintain control of my gun until it is secure. And now my gun is secure. Does that make sense? So let's go grip, lock, ready.